getting admission is not that difficult. After working in Germany for 2 years, you are entitled to permanent residence.
Really? Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jane. In this video, we're going to be talking about how to study in Germany for free, how to get permanent residence after your studies, and many other good stuff. So this video is actually a part two. In the part one of the video, please go and watch it. We started from the very beginning, from the requirements, how to apply, the fact that Germany offers free tuition, how to get additional funding for your living expenses, and many other questions. In this part of the video, we're going to be talking about how to get permanent residence, how to get visa, and other questions. So make sure you watch this video to the very end. Don't skip any parts that you will not miss any vital information. And also, after this video, the upcoming videos, I'm going to be bringing people from other countries, from UK, people that are studying under different scholarships, to come and tell us how to study in the UK for free. And don't forget to click the subscribe button if you've not subscribed, and also turn on the notification bell. One more thing, I would like you to type in the comment section saying thank you to Clement for his time and this knowledge that he has poured on us. Thank you so much, guys.
The admission for summer semester is over, so now you can start applying for winter semester, which starts by October this year. For summer semester, usually I think it starts by December, January. I know it takes 2 to 3 months before you get your admission. My case is special. I got my scholarship came late. My scholarship confirmation from DRD came late. So they had already concluded admissions for the semester, for winter semester. I basically got notification of my scholarship in June, and I cannot apply naturally, but because I have scholarship, so I took it upon myself to send me to admission office of some selected school that I want to attend. So I got reply from the professor. So they gave, because of my scholarship, I was given a priority access, kind of special consideration. So I didn't apply during the admission period. So that is also the benefit of having a scholarship. You become immediate priority and they attend to your case. And when you get to the embassy as well, you don't pay visa fee. They allow you to do your visa expenses free of charge. And usually, if you want to sponsor yourself, you need to book appointment for visa 3 months to you coming to Germany. But with scholarship, you can get an appointment within 1 week. So it's faster. So those are the things you need to put into consideration. If you want to like sponsor yourself and you want to come to Germany by, let's say, October this year, which means you need to apply now and get admission at least before May, or concurrently, you can, while applying for admission, you can also send a mail to the embassy to book an appointment for a visa interview, because it usually takes time. And let me mention that the German has changed the law now. The priority are those people who are recent graduates. That is, if you graduate from 2019 upward, you are in the first category. And those from 2018 downward, they are in second category. So which means those people who will likely get a date for visa interview are those people from 2019 upward. So it is when they've concluded those cases, they will now try to look at those who graduated from 2018 downward, because they are trying to now attract young international students. Yeah, it depends on how you do your application. I've seen some people in Netherlands that's the method they use, because if you have to wait for those steps, you have to wait for admission, maybe the school also is delaying. You know, by the time you now try to get your visa interview, they might say, no, we don't have time. And some people might even get it 3 months after the program has started. So which means it's also a burden on you when you decide to come to Germany. Some people usually try it and it works for them. Some people, it might not. But I think if you have a block account already, even without admission, and you send a letter to the embassy for interview, you might likely get interview date. At least with your block account, it shows intent that you want to actually come. So And I think if you apply on time and you have the necessary documents, getting admission is not that difficult. You have to go to the website, they have the requirement, but the basic requirement is your admission letter, your proof of funding. Your admission letter, your proof of funding. Then there are some other documents they will require from you. And it is really clearly stated from the embassy website. So you just have to... the accommodation is a bit tricky. Some people are lucky, they got the accommodation while they were staying in their home country. Some people, they network while they were in their home country. They met with other people who were already living in Germany to help them secure accommodation. While some people, they had to come to Germany before they could secure an accommodation. So there is an app to search for accommodation wherever you are in the world. They have an app that you can use to search for accommodation. Getting an accommodation, it depends on the area you are and the influx of students around the place. For instance, in my area, it is difficult to get accommodation, especially if you don't even understand the language, because there's always a language barrier. And the cost depends also on the area. You know, of course, you know, bigger cities, expensive, smaller city. So it also applies like that. They don't provide anything hostel. However, in some schools, the student service have some special accommodation, some accommodations reserved for students. So the criteria for you to access the accommodation is for you to be a student in that school. However, they are managed by the student service, not by the university. So it is none of the university business to provide accommodation for you. First, most people, when they want to apply to study abroad, the first thing they have in mind is, I want to get out of that country. I want to japa. Let me use the popular phrase they use. And that mindset is responsible for at least 70% of failures we have when we are applying, because you fail to convince the people you are applying to that you are the best candidate they should take. But whatever that is in your mind, you're cooking up stories and, you know, trying to lie, try to do all sorts of things to get admission. And one thing about Germany is that although it is good to have good grade, but it's not enough. So some people also in their application, the only thing they flaunt is, I have first class. Yes, we know you have first class. What else can you do? So those two things are one of the major hurdles people faces when trying to apply for a scholarship or admission abroad, and they don't get it. I remember after getting my I think there was one school I was applying to. They knew already I was having DRD scholarship. They also requested I write a motivation letter also why they should take me for that program. And what they are basically, what they want to know is, how well can you work within a team? How motivated are you? Because in science or in whatever research in graduate studies, being intelligent is not enough. So now how motivated are you when things are going against you, when everything is just working against you? How resilient are you? How can you pull through? So they want to see what you're made of from your statement of purpose, from your motivation letter, whatever you call it. So the mistake most people do is to flaunt about their grades. Yes, is enough, but then they want to see some difficult times you faced and how you were able to overcome them. How were you able to impact your immediate surroundings? How were you able to function well in a group? How were you able to meet some deadlines that were theoretically not possible? So those are the things they are looking forward in an application. And also, when you ask somebody to be a referee for you, be sure it's somebody that will truly put in good words for you. For instance, in Germany now, professors are treated like God. So if you get the professor recommendation in Germany, if you submit it to a scholarship body, unless your total application package is not really good, there is 50% chance that with professor recommendation letter, you will get through to the scholarship. So people we ask for recommendation also matters, not just people that will just write generic recommendation letter that everybody is writing. So it's not convincing, because when they ask for these things, they want to assess you through third party's view, people who have worked closely with you, how you were able to meet up with the schedules you were given? Are you able to function well in their group? Are you able to carry out the tasks assigned to you? Those are the things they are looking out for in all this application. Irrespective, even though you are not applying for scholarship, for admission alone, they want to see these things, because when you have international program that people from across the world come to attend, they want to know that these people that we are taking into our programs are those people who are going to be a good ambassador of our program, not people who keep dropping out year in, year out. So they want to have success story as well. So that they have to also screen people who come to attend their program. And these are the reason why they mostly request for a motivation letter and other what have you that you have in every application. There is one thing I need to share before I answer that question. Those people who prepare to carry out their further studies abroad, and they start maybe within 300 level of their studies, or maybe in final year, usually have more success story than people who graduated, went to NYC service, and then say, oh, let me look for a job. I didn't get a job. Okay, let me apply for scholarship. So it is usually tedious in that way, because first, you've lost contact with people who could have helped you. Second, assessing your lecturers back in school when you've left them is usually tedious, because some of them might have been transferred, some of them, you know, things like that. Also, some people, when they have intention that they want to go abroad to study, so while they were doing their bachelor's, they were already doing internships, some other extracurricular activities to improve their application overall. So, for instance, if you serve in an institute in Nigeria, you do your internship in an institute, or during your service, it was in an academic setting, or maybe NASDAQ, for example, an IT or a parastatal, the director general, the HOD of the department, can also give you a recommendation letter, because it's an academic setting. It's not necessarily just to be a professor from university. So, since you work with them during internship, for instance, and they are your direct supervisor, they know how you work, they can also serve as referee. So for the case of the person you mentioned, if I happens to be in that shoe, what I would do is just to do a voluntary internship in any educational setting related to my program, so that whoever that I work with can give me a good and a good recommendation letter. Because if you go back to meet someone and say, give me a recommendation letter, they will just write a generic stuff. And if it doesn't answer what they are actually looking for, especially in Germany, they really value the words of your referees. So they want to assess you through the person. So sometimes when they see generic recommendation letter, it means two things: either you're not serious or the person is lying just to protect you. So, whichever way, it doesn't improve your application. Actually, it is very straightforward in Germany. Once you're done with your studies, they give you 18-month visa to look for a job. So they call it job session visa. However, you need to also prove that within that 18 months, you can also sponsor yourself. So you have to show proof of living as well. However, when you get a job, then they will give you 2 years working visa. So after that 2 years visa, or your job might even be unlimited. But after that, after working in Germany for 2 years, you are entitled to permanent residence.
Really?
Yes. In all of this, language plays an important role. If you know the German language, you have added advantage to your job search.
There's going to be other videos coming up on how to get free scholarship to study in other countries like the UK. So make sure you come back for the next videos. Ah, the sun. Come on now. Okay, I'm gonna raise this up.